very special New Year's edition. The first, well, it's still 2016 when we film this.
Yeah. So but when you see it, it's going to be
2017. 2017. If we make it through the rest of the year.
Yeah, hopefully. Oh, yeah, you know. They're trying their best to get everybody.
You know, it's funny though. What I laugh every time someone posts like, "Damn you, 2016," blah blah blah. For me personally, 2016 has been awesome. I don't want it to end. I like it.
I don't know. Well, yeah. Okay, so personally,
oh wow, your tolerance is way.
It wasn't too
mine.
Bad either. I didn't die.
It's a good thing.
Almost. You barely made it through Christmas.
I wouldn't really call the common cold like me dying. I mean, I wasn't in a hospital or nothing.
He had TB. Don't let him lie to you. Oh. We all had to get vaccinated.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So,
Dead Rising 4.
That's what we're playing. Yeah. So, also, hang around to the very end of the podcast, because Nelson is going to be eating one of these bad boys. A full pound and a quarter. Of Reese cup.
I think I might have. I think I might have underestimated the size of the damn thing.
That's what she said.
I was trying to think of a way where that wasn't going to get said, but it's just not possible.
No.
Not in this case.
No, not at all.
Willamette.
All right, let's do this. Nelson, what are the buttons? X, okay, X to melee.
I was going
to
tell you. You're in the tutorial.
I know. We're playing Dead Rising 4. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Yes.
You. Oh! Mm! Get it! Where you Man. Live.
There's Rick. I'm sorry, there's Glenn. There's Glenn again.
Basically.
Why? There's Abraham. And now you got a hammer.
Bro. Oh,
that's right. Even this though this was like an hour. This is the tutorial. And they're just switching up weapons on you.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Have you never played Dead Rising again?
No.
No, remember, he's not been an Xbox guy.
Well, I know, but I mean.
Only the second one there's was on
PlayStation. Oh, no, these... Oh, why me? I'm hitting why me. There we go.
Three? The second one... Oh, three was Xbox One exclusive.
No, I'm sorry. PlayStation 3.
Oh, stop PS3. Listening.
Oh, yeah. PlayStation 3. Yeah, I think it was Dead Rising... Actually, I think they re-released Dead Rising 1.
Oh, is it? You're gonna like this weapon.
On PlayStation 3.
Yeah, they did. PlayStation 3 got Dead Rising 1. It might have gotten Dead Rising 2. I don't know if Dead Rising 2 was an exclusive at all.
Okay.
I can't remember.
I know 3, 1 and 3 were exclusives, but...
Yeah, I think 2 might have been the only one that they just started off as a...
I like that.
...multi-system.
I like that even better.
Yeah.
See, you know, and I come from an era where they made the same game for all platforms, and it just wasn't exclusive.
No!
Mostly, like, Sega got boned.
Yeah. If you go back and play, for sake of example, both the PlayStation, or not PlayStation, the Genesis version of the Power Rangers game, and then the Nintendo.
The Super NES.
Yeah, it was completely
different. Yeah, they might have
it was different, but I mean, but you still had the game there, though. You know what
you
I mean?
You had
but
it was a game with that name, yeah.
Yeah, because I mean, like, if you go back and play the Disney games for a Super Nintendo, always better because they were made by Capcom.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
And anybody who tells you that, Aladdin or Lion King for the Genesis is just as good as
the one for Super Nintendo.
They're liars.
You know,
so
I
the one
never
for,
played
for
the
Super Nintendo better?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, then I'll have to play that because that's actually the game that came with my Genesis. I was late in the game. No, 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 no.
Lion King.
Oh, Lion King? Yeah,
94? 94, I think. Whatever.
Get it how you live.
That, I think that was the only one where I played both the play or why do I keep wanting to say PlayStation? Damn it. both the Super NES version and the Genesis version. And
I'm close.
Lion King. I'll say this: they were very similar compared to other games that were on both systems. The layouts were the same and everything. I think it was just the graphics were better on the SNES version. And then the difficulty might have been different.
Okay.
So, but other than that, they were for the most part the same. Aladdin, I can't tell you whether or not that was the same or not.
I always wanted to play Aladdin, but I just didn't. I
need
the system first.
Have Have you always wanted to be that frustrated? I was like, I don't remember much about Aladdin. I remember it being frustrating to a degree.
Right.
But not like the I just want to be king level of Lion King. That,
we're not talking about that. We are not talking about that level.
Did you ever get past that level?
Oh, I got past it, but it took me a while.
Yeah, Aladdin for freaking Super Nintendo was so much fun.
Was it?
Yeah. The only really hard, frustrating level for that I can remember was the Magic Carpet Station, where you're level where you're trying to escape the cave.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Yeah, I do remember that.
Mm. Zombie Frank!
Ah! Tutorial over.
Mm. I'd like to thank my sister and my future brother-in-law for this beer stein can.
Also, thank you for this shirt, Shelly.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks for
the memories. Nothing. Thanks for the memories. Even though they weren't so great, beer tastes like you, only sweeter. Oh, am I the only Fallout Boy fan here?
You want to try? Yeah, you are.
All right. Oh, yeah. Yes, Izzo should have the honor since he has not played this before.
He probably should have done the tutorial then, but.
Oops.
I do wish that. I hope they have a patch later that this has drop in, drop out co op like 3 did.
That's what I'm hoping.
Because that was the best. So, moving on, we want to say congratulations to a good friend of the show. He was on our first episode with Halo via the interwebs. Victor got engaged on Christmas Day.
Nice.
So, congratulations, Victor.
Congrats.
Yay. Round of applause. He's also personal friends with Alexa Bliss, so I'm hoping she shows up to the wedding without her boyfriend.
How would you react if you were at that wedding and she showed up? Would you awesome con it? And you know what I'm talking about. Nice shirt.
Oh, yeah, with Jessica Chobot. No, I've had a crush on Chobot for a lot longer. So, I think I'd be cool.
Let's hope you're right.
I hope I'd be cool. Let's put it this way. On the off chance she showed up to the wedding, Murph would probably be there, and he's a lot bigger than me. So, I think I'd be fine.
Is he bigger than you? He doesn't look bigger than you.
Actually, you know what? I've only ever seen him standing next to her, and she's only 5 feet tall.
Oh, yeah. So, she makes everyone look gigantic.
Yeah.
Everyone looks like the Big Show next to her.
So, yeah, he might not be bigger than me, because I'm a pretty big dude. I'm bigger than Chris Jericho and Shawn Michaels.
I don't believe you.
At the time we met Shawn Michaels, I was bigger than Shawn Michaels, though. That preview for that movie that your mom that tagged us in?
No, I tagged everybody.
Oh, you tagged us in that?
Yeah.
Yeah, that preview, he looked even smaller. Pretty shocked.
He's in his 50s now. But no, speaking of that preview, and I don't want to make fun of my boyhood hero, but like, I never noticed it before until, I think it was a What Culture video.
Are you talking about his cross eye?
Yeah, I had never noticed that before, but oh shit, in that video, was it noticeable? That's like all I could stare at. And I don't even sound like a dick, but I was like, it's gotten worse.
Well, good for you, Josh, because I had noticed that since he came back to the WWE back in 2002.
About to kill you?
Yeah. Yeah, X.
Oh, he didn't take the picture. Oh, he has a Superman punch. I don't know how you did that, but that was awesome. Yeah, I had noticed that cross eye since 2002.
Yeah, see, I had never noticed it really before, but it's gotten like a lot worse.
Yeah, it has, especially in that preview.
I'll tell you one thing, though, and this is because I'm a vain son of a bitch, because that didn't happen to him until after he made his return back to the WWE.
Yeah.
I'd be like, every time I saw that in the mirror every morning, I'd be like, why did I come back? I've ruined my beautiful
Too many chair shots, man.
Yeah, I don't even know what it did that, but, oh.
So I'm gonna say it was the match with Mankind at Mind Games.
Probably. No, because it didn't happen until after he came back.
I feel like if you go back and watch his promos with Jose Lothario, it was starting back then. I vaguely remember it starting to cross back then.
Yeah. But we're gonna get this out of the way too, so we just did some good news and now some bad news, because this week, since our last podcast, Carrie Fisher, you have to take pictures, dude.
I am taking pictures.
No, you're not.
No, you got to use the trigger buttons. And now you're trying to take a selfie with freaking violence in the background.
Yeah, you didn't take a single picture.
You know what? I didn't go through the tutorial.
It's like, telling you on the screen how to do it.
Is it now?
Yeah.
Where is it? Show me.
Well, it's not anymore because you're not in the camera mode anymore.
This is not going to be good for our...
You're gonna have to restart the from the last checkpoint, because that's the whole goal.
Oh no, the tutorial's right there, in that menu. So you just gotta scroll through and find.
You know, hand this part over to Nelson. When fighting starts, Nelson will hand you back the controller. Well, now it's screwed though, because you have to take a picture of that.
It's gonna be okay.
It's gonna be okay.
You're fucking over my games, and I don't like when people fuck over my safe files.
I'm sorry.
You are sorry.
No, I'm not.
You are. Anyways, that big room, but yes, our condolences to Carrie Fisher. See, an F ranking. Thanks, dickhead.
You're welcome. That's what you get for giving me the controller.
Like Carrie Fisher and her mother both passed away. Which,
very sad.
When I heard about Debbie Reynolds dying, I wasn't surprised, because let's face it, if you've been in bad health and you're in your mid-80s and your child dies, you're going to go downhill, because one thing I've noticed in my years, that once you get to a certain age, there is the thing of will to live, and when elderly people feel they've got nothing left to live for, they end up just dying. Like, because it happened to my grandmother, like, she was the last one left, like, out of her friends. Her husband was dead and everybody. And she had kidney problems. And she had to go on dialysis and stuff like that. And basically, like, she died of natural causes. But the doctor was like, I've seen this, like, so many times. Just when people get that old and, like, they've got nothing, like, that they feel that's left for them, they just die. Mm. It's like the will to live, basically. Mm. So I bet you that's what happened to Debbie Reynolds. Like, she was old and in not the best health. And her daughter just died, so.
Right.
I mean, I think as a parent, anybody can kind of relate to that. Because as they say, that's like every parent's worst nightmare, except for zombies. Zombies are pretty bad, too.
Yeah, they suck.
Yeah. I don't have to say this.
But moving on to more cheerful things. Christmas recap. As you guys saw in our Christmas show beforehand, Izzo gave me these lovely lights that we're using, so we have better picture quality. Yes. I gave him awesome Power Rangers gifts.
Yes.
What you didn't see on camera, I gave Nelson was Frieza or Spider-Gwen?
Frieza Funko Pop.
Alright, Frieza Funko Pop and...
And you got...
Daredevil.
Yep.
Those happened on...
Not just regular Daredevil, yellow and red.
Yellow and red Daredevil figure, yes.
Because I didn't track that down.
Nelson and I are both terrible people. When we get gifts for people, we can't wait to give them to them, so we never, like, save them. Because literally, like...
Dude, well, I'm about to give you your birthday present, it ain't even January yet.
I know, it's not... No, because, like, Nelson, with Nelson's, though...
right there. There are things to kill right there.
Yeah. With Nelson's, though, the thing was, like, I was so afraid he was going to buy it for himself. I gave it to him early just so he wouldn't. Here.
Which is a fear.
Unless
you got me something adult, then that you don't have to fear.
Yeah, but that's not a good gift for you.
Well, it's a practical gift for me.
Right there.
There's more.
But, so Christmas recap. Nelson, what was your favorite Christmas gift you got?
Boom.
Like that. I can barely remember what I got right now. I would actually say my Alexa Dot. My Echo Dot.
Oh, that you got from your company?
From my company, yeah. Because that was way cooler than I thought it was.
That's actually what I got, one of my gifts from my mom. Actually, that was her birthday gift. Is it your favorite gift? The gift of not being sick anymore?
The gift Church. Of laughter?
No, seriously. life, man. I was, so...
Oh, pick up the Azacal problem.
Yeah, as you guys know, I was not here last week due to being sick.
Wait, weren't you?
Oh,
obviously, you didn't watch the podcast from last week.
Sure didn't. I joked on you.
Yeah, but there was a great intro.
I'm sure there was.
Because we had Devin here. So I was like, me, Nelson, Izzo.
Oh, yeah. Well, you told me that you were going to do that. So
yeah,
I didn't really miss out on that.
But, pick up. There's life in the corner right there. There's like food in your right corner.
Right corner.
Or actually, just hit the down button on the D-pad. Because you need to heal. Pick that up too if you can. And they're coming.
They're coming.
Nice.
There's a cool execution with that, so be aware of those buttons when it comes up.
Is Nelson, you tell him when to push it.
No, it'll show up.
It'll show up.
Okay, other than the gift of life, what was your favorite Christmas gift?
Yeah, honestly, I would have to say the Megazord. All my other
there it is!
Oh! definitely the most...
Some decent gifts. But
probably the most practical gift I got were the lights that we're using, because probably I'll get the most use out of those.
You better.
Favorite gift I would have to say. I got a couple of them. our new co-host over there, Brawley. That was my gift from my son.
Oh, you know what? I changed my vote. It was the gifts from your mom.
Oh, the action figures?
Yeah. Take Winter me. Soldier, Falcon, and a box full of cookies. Like I am 10 years old, but I am good with that.
Right? I told my mom what you said about not having enough frosted cookies in that thing. She's like, I know. She's like, those are the best ones in that.
They are the best ones. Yeah. There was like four in there. I ate all of them.
Son of a bitch, man. I was going to take one.
Oh, no, you didn't get a chance
no,
to.
No, I didn't. You ate them all.
But I did not know until I ate them all that there were chocolate frosted ones in there, too.
No, I didn't know about that. Are those all gone, too?
There may be one left, but they're probably all gone. Hey, I didn't eat any of the chocolate chip because I knew you liked those, and there was just too many other flavors for me to be like, chocolate chips, what I want right now.
Granted, it's not one of my favorite gifts, but it's kind of a cool gift, the beer can snipe from thinkgeek.com, which I also got. My future brother-in-law as well.
That was funny. Both opened up the exact same gift on more than one occasion.
And then Santa brought me this cool t-shirt from the No Rooster Teeth that's got all the old school video game stuff on it. I love this shirt.
That was a cool shirt.
I got a bottle of whiskey, which is always good. Canadian whiskey. You gotta take a picture of that disco ball thing. That looks kind of like the thing from...
Dancing.
What was that game? Portal.
Oh, like the portal gun?
Yeah. No, not the portal gun. It looks like the boss. GLaDOS.
Oh, GLaDOS.
It's like GLaDOS. Kind of.
Oh, no. There's more stuff you got to take pictures of. There's, like, stuff in the back. Like that thing next to the chick. Yeah, there.
A chick named Vic. Terrible name. Hey, Victor, you're in the game.
Hmm. Congrats, by the way, again.
Yes, again, congrats.
There's some Zombrex over to your right.
What else did I get?
More over to the right. Those boxes over there. Zoom in.
Yep.
Oh, my mom got me these cool Lucky Brand jeans.
You are in my way.
Which are expensive as fuck. Thank you, Mom. that was really cool.
Am I done with this camera thing now?
Yeah. My mom spoils the shit out of us.
I will admit, selfie mode does make me laugh. There's a keypad over there for the door.
Okay.
You got to take one more picture.
My sister also got me a Homer Simpson little, like, figure for my desk that I put up at work.
Nice.
I need to get a freaking Homer Simpson thing for my desk. That's what I'm missing.
Because when I was opening up the package and I saw Simpsons, like, that was, like, it's like a little minifig. I was like, I was thinking to myself,
get
it's better be fucking Homer.
Get out of my way or I will kill you.
Because I was like, if this is, like, Bart, I'm going to be pissed. Because Bart is, like, my least favorite Simpsons character.
And Homer's your favorite, right?
Yeah. Oh, easily.
Yeah.
Close second, Mr. Burns.
Because he's an idiot.
Yeah, and he's the funniest one.
I like Mr. Burns.
That's when the show really started getting good, though. Like, I think it was like season two, halfway through season two, when they realized Homer's the star, not Bart.
Yeah.
So you watch those early first season episodes, like, man.
Season three is when it started clicking, really started clicking.
Oh, yeah. Season three is when they hit their stride. Usually, like... Most shows towards the end of season two into season three is when shows really hit their stride.
If they make it that far.
Yes.
Right.
And some shows deserve to make it that far and don't. Yeah. And then other shows just keep going, Walking Dead, and don't deserve to keep going.
How I Met Your Mother.
No, that show's great. They had a lull.
They had a very long
but
lull.
Season seven, like half of season six and season seven are kind of lull. 8 was pretty good. 9's fucking fantastic, though. Season 9 is hilarious. Non-stop laughter.
The show that
I don't like how they wrapped it up, though.
I love how they wrapped it up. It was a perfect wrap-up.
Well, and then, you know, there were the edited versions on YouTube, the happy edits that were... So you got to see how that played out.
I was never a big fan of that. I like, because, like, I had told you, I'd figured that shit out by, like, season 6 or 7 that the mother was dead. Well, I shared it with you later, but I told you when I figured it out, because I was like, it might spoil it for you, and you're like, okay, and you told me not to tell you. But I did.
And luckily for me, I forgot until you told me again during the season, last season. I can't remember...
Investigate the story.
Yeah. There's probably...
You gotta look for... Like, go back to that room that you were in.
Yeah, because your indicator isn't even on the map anymore.
All right.
You gotta... yeah, there you go.
Did you take any pictures in this room?
No, they just said to turn on my night vision.
You gotta go over here and watch a video, that's right.
Oh, that's right, yeah. Okay. Yeah, we're doing this with completely the sound off, which is why I was watching Nelson play this earlier, so I could get this part of the story for when I play.
Though I will say, playing around on that go-kart was starting to get me dizzy.
Alright, so moving past Christmas. Everybody had a happy Christmas, right?
Yes.
Alright.
Yeah.
Oh, you were sick, but... Yeah. Oh, it was funny, when I told my mom on Christmas Day you were sick, she's like, I gotta get some food together for him, and by the time I left, we all forgot about it.
Thank you for that.
But there's a bunch of meats and cheeses in my fridge if you want any.
In my defense, I was tired as shit when I left my mom's house Christmas evening. I was ready to go home.
This is the face of a man that doesn't care. Even get any pie, okay?
It's alright.
Yeah. Sure, a bunch of pepperoni and cheese in my fridge, dude. All from leftovers.
Alright, so... Now, the big story that I want to talk about here, because it was slow news week, because it's the end of the year. So, there's been a rise in retro gaming, retro media stores. Like, in our area, we've got one of those Second and Charles stores, and then about 30 minutes north of us, there's like a dedicated retro store that has like toys, records, and video games. Mm-hmm. And one thing I've noticed from these stores, like, especially if they offer trade-ins, they used to be good. Like, Second and Charles, when it first opened up, offered great deals for... used games, and their prices were pretty low. Mm-hmm. But then, now recently, like, their prices have been pretty high. Like, we were in there last week, and they had a gold cartridge Zelda for the Nintendo, mm-hmm. which I wanted to get because I just wanted to have for nostalgia purposes because I used to have it, and I don't have that game anymore. Yeah. I still got Zelda 2, it's up on the wall up there. But I asked to see it, and I looked at the price. Like, they won $46 for this, a Nintendo cartridge.
That was ridiculous.
And so I was like, and I had seen it cheaper on eBay, so I went on eBay later that night, bought it for $18.
Oh, and then there was that copy of Animal Crossing, too. You're like, no, it's Animal Crossing. It's like, I don't want to pay $24
for it. And I hopped on eBay, and it was like $10.
Yeah, you get it for
$10.
And
it's so funny, too, because I remember when we asked them, like, how they gauge their prices, and they gave us a couple things that they... do their price, and they go, oh, and the, like, average price on eBay.
Where do I need to go?
You have to use your camera.
Yeah, there's a filter.
Yeah. Spectrum analyzer.
And then go take a picture of that and hold down the button.
Yeah, take a picture of it. And they said, like, eBay was a big thing, like, the average price of eBay, which is a crock of shit when you think about it.
Yeah.
You gotta get it in focus. Go down? Nope.
The keypad itself.
Yeah, take a picture. Oh.
And then, take a picture, hold it down.
And they were saying, like, eBay was, like, a big factor, but every time, like, I've seen a game that I like there and I check out the price, I always check eBay. And eBay's usually, like, half of what they're charging.
Yeah.
Right. So it's like, what, are you taking the average price of eBay and then doubling it? Is that how you figure
it out? That's what it seems like.
And then when we went up to that retro gaming store at Springfield Mall, I had a lot of cool stuff there. But I remember we looked at one game, and it was like $10, and I was like, "Yeah, I've seen the same game on eBay for $2."
Xbox, $2. Stop listening.
Stop listening. And I told you, like, I'd seen the same game, like, several listings on eBay for like $2, $4.
Yeah.
So it's just kind of ridiculous. You want to hit the lure thing to get them over there? It might not let you just yet.
Yeah, it's monologuing right at the moment.
And it's just kind of like, they've got a lot of cool things, but the way they charge, and I remember, like, while we were sitting there, like, looking at some of the cool stuff there, someone asked how much they wanted for a Nintendo, and was it like $70 or $100?
Yeah, something like that.
Without a game. And I'm talking about old Nintendo, Great Box NES. Not an N64, not a Wii, but a freaking Nintendo.
Yeah.
And it's just one of the, and as soon as they get over there to get the meat, you just hit the purge. Yeah. All right, go ahead. There it goes. Now they burn up. But, yeah, it's just kind of like, man, it's like, it just seems like these retro are, like, basically trying to scalp our nostalgia. It's like, oh, you really like this game? And they try to, and I could see, like, a store doing that back in the 90s. Mm-hmm. Because there was like no eBay, there was no internet for the most part.
Yeah, there were no other options but.
Yeah, but your local stores, you couldn't really shop online for anything. But you have so many options nowadays. You can go to eBay. You can just like Google search retro games and find a bunch of online stores to buy stuff.
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm.
So.
Or places like Stone Age Gaming that allow you to use your ROMs in old systems.
Yeah. So, I mean, trying to charge, like, ridiculous amounts of prices for things these days, it's how do you stay in business for the most part?
Yeah.
Because, like, there were a couple cool things we saw in that store, and I was like, I'm not even going to ask how much this costs, because I already know they're going to charge a dick load for it.
Yeah, the second time we went, I noticed some stuff, too. I was like, oh, man, I'm not even going to ask.
Yeah.
Because I know, they're going to gouge me. Mm-hmm. It's cool to look at. Those stores, but man, if your prices are that high, you're just gonna price yourself right out of business.
Yeah,
right.
Because there is a threshold.
Though there were a lot of suckers in that store buying
stuff. Oh man,
like, do you guys not have eBay? Cause that's the really first not. Thing. That's like the first thing I ever do when I'm in a retro store or if we're at a con and I'm looking at some old games or old toys.
Yeah.
I will throw up eBay and see what the price is for eBay, and you've seen me haggle with people.
Yeah.
Like at cons, I'm like, hey, you know. I'm looking this up on eBay right now. It's half of what you got it for. You do this price so I can walk out of here with a day. I'll buy it. Sometimes they agree. Sometimes they don't. But yeah.
One of these days, you're going to walk out of there with a freaking virtual boy.
Probably. I get the right
price. I don't know why you want to, though.
Because that's the only Nintendo
just
system
to have
I've
it
never
on the
owned.
Shelf is what he wants.
It's the only Nintendo system I've never owned.
And it's going to be from that one place that you got the sticker for on your wagon. I forget their name. The Tech something or other.
Oh, yeah. The shop down in Richmond?
Yeah. Probably. Yeah, it's probably going to be them.
I kind of wish I could think of their name right now, give them a free plug, because they do have clothes. Because we've been to the shop before.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Did we make a special trip for down there for that, for Richmond? Did we go to Richmond just for that, or were we already down in Richmond?
That was a different store.
I thought it was the same one.
No.
You sure?
I hadn't heard of the Tech, I think it was the Tech Exchange?
Yeah, I think
so. I hadn't heard of them until the first time I went to AwesomeCon.
I'm certain it's the same one. I think you're wrong. You're wrong.
Whatever.
I'm gonna go with you wrong.
Okay, I don't care.
Oh shit, I forgot something. Alright, you guys talk amongst yourself. I gotta go get something from upstairs. Because I forgot something. Because I have to go over my top 100 games and I don't want to use the website for it.
You son of a. We're talking about how much Josh just failed. As he ran out of the podcast.
Like a little girl.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know what's happening there. So. I don't know. Oh, yeah, just take a picture of that board up there, too.
What board?
To the left. Yeah, take a picture of that. And then there's something in the corner you need to take a picture of. Go turn to the right. That thing in the corner, use the spectral analyzer. No, the to your right.
But it,
Yeah.
And I'm back. So, what'd you dickheads talk about while I was gone?
How you ran upstairs like a girl.
Okay, so, if you go to the website, you know, this, for the last 10 weeks, and it just so happened to, like, right before New Year's, I was able to finish it. Mm. Timed that shit perfectly, by the way. Mm. So that's what I was kind of hoping for. It's like, if I don't have enough, I'm gonna go 2 weeks in a row to make it into the New Year. So, top 100 console games of all time. Number 100, Kirby's Adventure. 99, Ninja Gaiden. Number 98, okay. Middle Earth, Shadow of Mordor. 97, Wave Race 64. 96, Tatsunoko vs. Capcom. 95, NHL 94 or 93. You can sub those twos out. 94, Super Return of the Jedi. 93, Donkey Kong, original, on the NES, Atari, and ColecoVision. I personally first played it on the ColecoVision, got the cartridge right over there. First video game I ever played.
Are you really going through this entire
thing? Yes, I am. 92, Nights into Dreams. Which is Austin Creed, our good friend at Up Up Down Down, his favorite game. That game, he was awkward as a child, and he made it, and it helped him out. Number 91, Jet Force Gemini, N64, one of the best co-op games ever made. Number 90, Pinball on the Nintendo, one of my favorite games. And in fact, I remember it, it's Christmas story, so this works. On Christmas,
making me thirsty.
When I was like, I think I was like 5 or 6 years old, I was going to stay up all night and see Santa. And my mom gave my older sister Jenny the job of, you keep him in the room. He is not allowed out. I was like, but I want to stay up and see Santa. No. So Jenny and I literally all night long played pinball on the Nintendo. It's one of my all-time favorite Nintendo games. 89, Streets of Rage on the Sega Genesis.
Yes.
88, Madden 93. 87, Ghosts and Goblins, 86, Wii Sport, 85, X-Men and X-Men 2 on the Sega Genesis, 84, Dead Rising 3, coincidence, we're playing Dead Rising 4, 83, River City Ransom, great co-op game.
I love how that keeps popping up.
82, F-Zero, 81, Power Stone 1 and 2, 80, Pac-Man, on the Nintendo, because the other versions of Pac-Man suck, 79, NBA Jams, 78, God of War, the series, because they're all the same. 77, MLB The Show for the PS3. That was a great series. 76, Aladdin and the SNES. As we said earlier, the Sega Genesis version sucks. 75, Sonic Adventures on the Dreamcast. 74, Chrono Cross, the sequel to Chrono Trigger. Chrono Cross was an underrated sequel. A lot of fun. Great soundtrack. 73, Mario Party. 72, Jet Set Radio on the Dreamcast. Love that game. Worth owning a Dreamcast 4. First really to use the cel-shaded graphics. Awesome. 71, Uncharted 1 through 3. A lot of people like that game, think it should be higher on the list. They're wrong. It's an okay game. It's very easy. All it's got is a lot of set pieces. 70, Tecmo Bowl for the Nintendo. 69, Punch-Out, or Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, or Punch-Out featuring Mr. Dream, whichever you want to do. 68, Eco and Shadow of the Colossus, kind of the same game.
Weapons.
67, Rystar. Very underrated game, Rystar was.
I remember Rystar.
Team Sonic made it, and it was also awesome. I showed it to you on the Sega Genesis.
I have it on the Game Boy Advance.
It's fantastic.
There are the pieces for that weapon right
there. 66, Rocket League. The only way to get me to like soccer is add monster trucks. 65, Forza Horizon 3. 64, Animal Crossing for the GameCube. Great game, a lot of fun. 63, Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2. 62, Borderlands 2. 61, Fallout 3 and Fallout 3 New Vegas. Both kind of, one was kind of an expansion to the other.
Telling you to make the weapon.
60, Conquer Bad Fur Day. 59, Call of Duty 4, Modern Warfare. 58, Shovel Knight. Brand new, it's not brand new, it's like a year old Mega Man kind of clone. A lot of fun. 56, NFL 2K1. Maybe the best football game ever made. 55, Mega Man 2. 54, Castlevania. 53, Gran Turismo. 52, Spider-Man, the movie 2. 51, Legend of Zelda, The Twilight Princess. 50, Skyrim. 49, The Last of Us. 48, Resident Evil 4. 47, Mario Kart Double Dash. And if you don't like Mario Kart Double Dash, Austin Creed will fight you. 46, Metal Gear Solid 5. 45, Grand Theft Auto 5. 44, Mario RPG. 43, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Turtles in Time. 42, The New Tomb Raider series. 41, Fallout 4. 40, Mortal Kombat. 39, Gears of War 1 through 4, because they're all kind of the same. 38, the Batman Arkham series. 37, Pokemon Snap. 36, Kingdom Hearts. 35, the Banjo-Kazooie series on the N64. Not that crap they made on 360 Nuts and Bolts. That game sucks. 34, Marvelous Capcom and Marvelous Capcom 2. Both kind of the same game. Both awesome. 33, Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. 32, Splatoon. A shooter made for kids that adults love. Unlike Call of Duty, a shooter made for adults that kids love. 31, the original Bioshock. 30, Mario Maker. 29, Metal Gear Solid. 20...
Should go to the end of the hall first. There's something over there.
I don't want
to
open it.
My list got screwed up.
Not yet. Just 20, you're Overwatch. Not gonna be able to go back.
I'm sorry, 28, Dark Souls. 27, Halo 2 and 3. 26, Red Dead Redemption.
You don't need that.
25, Tetris. 24, Red Dead 24, Tetris. 23, Overwatch. 22, Super Mario World. 21, Final Fantasy 3, a.k.a. Final Fantasy 6 here in the West. Number 20, the Smash Brothers series. 19, Eternal Darkness. That game was awesome for the GameCube. If you get a chance to buy Eternal Darkness, just read the thing on the website. It's fantastic. Freaking messed with me mind. 18, the original Legend of Zelda. 17, Street Fighter 2 Turbo Edition. 16, Star Fox 64 on the Star Fox 64. I don't know why I wrote SNES next to that. That's a weird note. 15, Contra. 14, Double Dragon 2, which you saw Izzo suck at earlier. On an old podcast. 13, Final Fantasy 7, which is not the best Final Fantasy. We'll get there. 12, Sonic 1 through 3 and Sonic and Knuckles. 11, Mario Kart 64. 10, is the best Final Fantasy ever, Final Fantasy 9. If you disagree with me, I will fight you and I will win. Number 9, Super Mario 64. Number 8, GoldenEye 64. 7, Donkey Kong Country. 1 is my personal favorite, but 2 is also really good. 6, Super Mario 1, 2, and 3. They're all great. Number 5, Nelson, I know you're going to agree with this. The THQ wrestling games, WWE and the WCW games, they are fantastic. Number 4, Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. This could also be switched to number 3, Legend of Zelda Link to the Past. They're kind of 3A, 3B. I both love them equal. It's kind of the reason why I put Link to the Past ahead of it. First Zelda game I actually ever owned, and I loved it so much. Got it with my 64, my Super Nintendo on my 10th birthday, which was the gift from my grandmother. My mother got me the Super Nintendo and Super Mario, Madden with that. Number 2, Bioshock Infinite. Awesome game. the only game from the last generation to make it to the top 10, and number one, the greatest game of all time, and if you will disagree with me, Izzo will fight you, Chrono's Trigger. Greatest game ever.
I have a question.
All right.
Because this sounded wrong to me.
What?
You said Final Fantasy X.
Mm. No, 10. Number 10 was Final Fantasy 9.
Okay.
Yeah, that Final Fantasy 10 you. Sucks.
Yeah, I was like, did I just hear you say Final Fantasy 10 was the best one? I was like, I thought you hated that one. I never
I am on record of saying the last good Final Fantasy was Final Fantasy 9. A lot of people are raving about 15. I might give that a try when it goes down in price. And I have
I've heard that.
I've got too many games to play right now.
Yeah.
I don't like the action RPG combat in Final Fantasy 15.
I hadn't played it yet, so I don't know what the system's like. All I know is when I played Final Fantasy 11 in the demo for 12, I was like, nope, I'm out. I'm done. This is
Wasn't 11 annoying. Online?
Huh?
Wasn't 11 an MMO RPG?
One of them was. I don't remember which one. Right. But there was a demo. It was a demo for 12, I think, because it came with a Dragon Quest 8. I'll have to look at my copy because I think I still have that. But it was a weird. Even though it was a demo, I hated the system because it was action RPG. But then the menus still worked almost identically. So you are running around trying to dodge stuff in real time and trying to access stuff in a menu.
That's not fun.
That's not fun at all.
Okay. So let's do our top five games of 2016. Though you didn't really buy any video games this year, so you're exempt from this one.
That's fine.
Go, Nelson. Top five games of 2016.
My favorites. Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2, which was surprising to me. Overwatch. Gears of War. Oh, WWE 2K17. Did he even have five games? I can't even think of what else.
All right, so you got top four. So my top... I'll give you my top eight, since I did a top eight list for the website.
Mm.
Number eight, Unravel. That was a surprise sleeper hit right
but
there.
But I hadn't played it, so it was fun to watch.
Though. Number seven, which we promised you the series, we haven't put it up on the site yet, Overcooked.
Oh, yeah.
Our favorite game to play together. Number six, Gears of War 4. Five, Super Hot.
Oh, yeah, that's I didn't really play that one. I watched you play that, so that's why.
Number four might have been the most addicting game of the year, Pac-Man 256.
Yeah.
I still need to buy that.
That was a game that was just like, oh, I'm just going to play it for a minute. An hour later, Nelson walks out of his room. You're still here? I got hooked in.
Dude, and you went to sleep at like 3.
I know, that game.
It was like a work night.
Because you get on like a string, and you're just like, I'm going to beat that score now. And I love that game.
I knew something was up when I was like, I can still hear him playing when I'm
number three was a surprise to me, just because when the beta came out, I really didn't like the beta, but Doom. Doom was awesome. And it was just like
really?
A return
I thought
to...
you didn't really like it that much.
Oh, I did.
Old school Doom? Or...
Yeah, it was a return to old school Doom. There was like, okay. The only story was, demons came from hell and are taking over the Mars base, and you're some silent guy who just wrecks shit. Okay. It was a lot of fun.
I like it.
Yeah. Number two, Rocket League. Because that came out in 2015 on PC, but not until 2016 on consoles.
I wasn't sure. I almost
and that game was so much fun. Like I said in my top 100, the only way to get me to like soccer is to add monster trucks to it. And then number one, no surprise if you know me, Overwatch. My favorite game of the year.
Overwatch is great.
Awesome game. So that is my top five games of the or top eight games of the year. So we'll go on to favorite movies of the year. Izzo, you can start this one.
What I will not say is Batman vs. Superman, because that movie was horrible.
Oh, that was on my worst movie of the year.
That was on his...
So I will say Civil War.
Civil War is your favorite?
Yeah. So I actually got a chance to watch it again last night, because the first time I watched it, I kind of glazed through a couple things. The only... I didn't really like the whole Spider-Man thing, but that's just me. But other than that, I mean, I really like...
Because you hate
fun? I hate whiny, talkative people that just don't fight a whole lot. I mean, Spider-Man didn't do a whole lot of that.
What are you talking about? He beat up two guys!
Compared to what everybody else was doing in the movie.
He beat up Falcon and Winter Soldier.
He talked too much.
That's what he does.
I know.
That's what Brawly does.
This one, maybe.
But no, but I mean, I think this year, I mean, but honestly, for me personally, it's been a slow year in terms of movies. Mm-hmm. So I have to give it to Captain America.
All right. And Nelson, your top movies of the year.
My top movies. Top of that list is probably Civil War.
You need to keep Brad alive, right? You got to go over where he's at and keep the zombies off him.
Yeah. I don't care about Brad.
Oh, you're going to lose the game. He's over by the crates. There are crates, by, I think, behind you.
Behind me?
Yeah, or to your... All
right, so Nelson, what are your favorite
movies? Top of that list, depending on the day. Today, it's going to be Civil War, because I've watched that a couple times again.
Right.
You need a gun out of that crate, or a machete.
And then Deadpool, 10 Cloverfield Lane, Nice Guys.
I'm going to take the base. Hold up.
Nice Guys came out this year, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Nice Guys.
That made my list.
Yeah, that was definitely another good one. That's four,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. You can just do four. You don't have to do five.
I think there's one more in there.
Well, maybe you can add one when you hear my list.
I liked X-Men, so I'll throw that number five.
All right, my top seven. Seven was Star Trek Beyond.
I'm surprised you put that one on there.
What? I love that movie. I was saying it while we were watching.
I liked it. I just didn't realize you liked it that much.
I enjoyed it immensely.
Yeah, okay.
And when you got Idris Elba, usually I'm going to like you. 10 Cloverfield Lane.
Mm-hmm.
That was a nice, claustrophobic, creepy vibe movie.
I remember when you talked about the review for that movie.
There's a bag to your left.
It's really good. Number five, Deadpool.
A bag?
Yeah, like a duffel bag right there.
Deadpool was a lot of fun, but it was very basic. So it was tough to, put it higher than that. Yeah. Number four for me was Nice Guys.
Okay.
Really funny movie, and you know me, Nelson, I love me some Shane Black.
Yep.
Number three, Captain America Civil War. For all the reasons you guys said, except I liked Spider-Man, fuck you.
Whatever.
Number two, Doctor Strange. Because I know you two haven't seen that yet.
Yeah, I haven't.
Doctor Strange is great. And then my number one movie of the year, and it's a sleeper. Everyone should find this movie.
Ghostbusters.
And rent it. Fuck no. Everybody wants some.
I keep forgetting that movie came out this year.
From the writer-director of...
Brad at a hotel,
Everybody forgot it came out. Because no one went to see it. I didn't even see it in theaters. I didn't see it until
it
was for
it
rent.
I didn't existed until you
rented it. Because remember, I rented it because I bought that gift card to buy some shit on Pokemon Go. And I was like, I'll rent Everybody Wants Some because I want to see that.
There's actually someone down there you can save. Right down there. But that takes a lot.
Can I jump down there like they are?
I wouldn't recommend it because that hurt me.
Everybody wants some from the right.
But if you go back to the left, you can climb down and see where that stack of bricks is at. You can climb down from there.
As I was saying, Everybody Wants Some from the writer director of Days Infused. Hilarious, underrated movie.
Yes.
It's basically like, because all the other movies, sure, everybody likes all the trailers for, but Everybody Wants Some, basically, it follows the weekend of this college baseball team before school starts and just their hijinks. It's freaking hilarious. It's such an ensemble cast, and it's a bunch of people we've never heard of, and they do a great job. But even though it's an ensemble cast, everyone feels like you get their due. Like, you get to know each character, and even some of the ones that at the very beginning of the movie you're kind of like, that guy's kind of an asshole. Towards the end of the movie you're like, I kind of like that guy.
Right. Yeah.
So it was really cool. It's really funny. So definitely go rent it if you get the chance. I would say buy it, because I've watched that movie at least 7 or 8 times.
Oh wow.
Oh, it's fantastic. It's so close to replacing Hot Tub Time Machine as my feel-good movie. Yeah.
Ooh.
So it's very close. Yeah, considering, like, whenever I'm feeling low, throw a Hot Tub Time Machine in there. Instantly, I feel better.
Yeah,
Everybody Wants Some is approaching that level of
the funny thing about Everybody Wants Some, though, it feels so much like a sequel to Dazed and Confused.
Yeah.
I forget that movie came out this past year.
Yeah, Dazed and Confused was a Universal. I don't think Universal did this one, which is probably why, because... Dazed and Confused takes place in 1976, and we follow this rising freshman who's a pitcher. Well, this takes place in 1980, and we're following our main character that we're introduced first is a rising freshman pitcher. So I think it's basically a, kind of a sequel to Dazed and Confused, but because it was a different studio, it couldn't be. It's a, like a lot of people say about it, it's a spiritual sequel.
Yeah.
So I think basically,
and it really feels like it too.
It does. I mean, you got the same writer director. I mean, it's not hard to have that same feel, but yeah.
Well, not unless your name is Troy Duffy.
Yeah, I think he was a one hit wonder.
I hate to say it, but I think you're right because. That Boondock Saints sequel was not good.
But on that note, that's the end of the show, Nelson. Which means...
Oh, I was actually about to say, hand me the freaking thing.
It's time for your challenge.
So the rest of it, this episode is just going to be me eating this and enjoying watching.
Yes, and actually, no. Pause the game, because we're going to cheer him on.
Really? It's going to take me a while to eat
this. It ain't going to take you a while. Well, put it this way, if it takes you a while... You edit it or time lapse this. Oh my god, look at this. Wow. Look at this cup. Look at it. Look at that. Look, that is like an inch big. That is, man, that's like half the size of my penis right there.
Is he looking at where the freaking camera is?
I don't think he is.
Why are you touching it? I wash my hands.
We'll just give you
that. At some point. Look at that.
He's holding both of them. Oh no, he's holding one. Look at that. Oh, jeez.
Just go. Enjoy this.
You know, my biggest fear is, and I wish I had never seen that freaking YouTube video. Someone cut something like this open and there was a spider in it.
That's just, that's
I'm not eating it.
That's just like the Kinder Surprise. That's what that candy's called in Europe, right? Kinder?
Kinder egg.
Yeah, it's like Kinder egg. And let me know if you feel like you're going to puke because I'll run and get something because I don't want you puking on my carpet.
Get something now.
Yeah, I probably should.
And what about that tin? No one ever.
No, likes, there's popcorn in there.
No one ever likes what's in those tins.
No, it's got caramel popcorn.
Like I said, no one ever likes what's in those tins.
Shut your mouth. How is it? And Nelson, if you finish that too quickly, you gotta move on to the second one.
Mm-mm. I can't do the second one, not today. Just start the game back on, man. Or you don't have to watch.
Nelson. I'm gonna get these weapons, though.
Oh, did you not save that lady?
No, he didn't.
I'm just going to have to restart this game.
Yeah, he probably should.
You were just...
He's too enthralled.
He's not a completionist.
Because this is what he could never have in GTA.
Go fucking... Zombies. Are you going to buy an Xbox yet?
You need to.
Time soon.
Why?
There are like 4 or 5 games already that you want to play.
Actually, we need to find out if they're region locked. They probably are, but if they're not, you can probably get it really cheap when we go to Japan.
Why would I go to Japan and buy?
Because you might save money on it.
That's the dumbest idea ever.
American
system. Oh, stick around longer. I'll have dumb ideas. So Nelson, how's that cup treating you? You regret?
I made a mistake.
You made a terrible idea. I'm gonna have to help you edit this because we gotta do some funny shit while you're eating this. The dog is off camera looking at you, thinking, I need some of that in my life.
That'd be the last thing she ever said.
She's staring at Brawly, though. That's like her new best friend is Brawly. Took a nice little picture of her sleeping next to Brawly.
That's her new friend. She'll never be lonely again, actually.
I know.
Is that your new friend, Taylor?
Yeah, it is.
She has no more need for me.
What are you doing, Izzo?
I want grenades.
You're like the world's worst.
You're full up.
Yeah, you have grenades.
Yeah, you're full of grenades. You need to start throwing them.
Yeah, and there's guys coming at you, so you need to start throwing them.
It's the left trigger.
Left trigger?
Yeah.
Left bumper, I think you mean, because he's aiming.
Oh, yeah, left bumper. Sorry, my bad.
Well, at this point, I need to help this guy out, so...
Yeah, save the grenades
for... Less talky, more Edie from you.
There's a swarm of zombies coming up after these guys.
Oh, that was a headshot. Nice.
Every once in a while.
There they come. You better chuck that grenade.
How?
Left bumper.
I got bounced off his head.
Shoot that one, though. Like, don't throw a grenade in that close. Chuck another one.
Hmm. Oh, now you got Molotov, so.
Yeah.
Throw those, because you still got more.
Yep. Oh, you're lucky it hit some. Start throwing them. They're getting close, and you're on fire. This is on fire.
You really are on fire. Yeah, don't throw those Molotovs so close.
Yeah.
Looks like you're out. There's more. You got Molotovs.
I like how Izzo's just letting that guy do all the work. You know, that guy kind of looks like Corey Graves.
I know.
There you go. There's one guy right there.
Oh, jeez, this is a mistake.
Oh, you gotta eat it all. Climb that mountaintop, Jason. Climb it.
Oh, yeah, pick up those plants.
Propane tank? What the?
Ooh, you might be able to make an IED if you pick up those plants. To the left of you. That little scroll down there. Oh, it's the Blambo. Oh! Actually, you should make that.
Okay, fireworks versus a crossbow.
Well, they're all gone now.
Yeah, I definitely have to restart this game. Thanks, Izzo.
You still recording?
Yeah, we're still recording, because we're waiting for him to finish that.
I made a mistake.
No, you did not.
You're making me sick.
That is a pound and a quarter. That is like... Dude, that is 5 quarter pounder with cheeses.
You're right.
Man.
Math.
I'm good at it.
I'm not. I made a mistake.
Oh, no, you read this wrong, Jason. It says 2 half-pound cups. There's only a half-pound of a cup, so you need to eat this one, too.
I'm not eating that.
We promised them a pound and a quarter.
I can't eat that.
We promised our viewers a pound and a quarter.
This is a mistake.
Yeah, it's a mistake that you're not even halfway done yet.
Mm-hmm. I'm still going to do another one. I'm not eating
that. It was his idea.
I'm not eating that. I can't. Oh.
Don't worry, when you're sleeping and I'm breaking into your room and shove it down your throat and film it, we'll tack it on the end of this video.
It's called a snuff film, Josh. What the hell?
No, not if you don't die. What's this? It's a mattress. Forget breathy. Yeah, you can just like throw the reef on the zombie and look funny.
But you can actually turn that into a
too. That guy came right out at you.
There's a thing, if you add a battery to it, it electrocutes the zombie.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, there's a racing thing. There's a go-kart. You can hop on that go-kart track, Izzo, and you can race. You can do what you love to do.
Mow down zombies.
Yeah.
With a car.
Gotta jump. There you go. How does he get in the car, Izzo? Nelson?
I think it's like B.
Yep, B.
Yeah, let me clear out.
No, you will clear them out while you're in the go-kart.
This is a racing game.
Yep. RT to accelerate. Go! You gotta...
That was the weakest. Really? I mean,
pretty much. It's just so you can unlock
stuff.
Stuff. Yeah, because you're gonna get what's in that cage, which is plans for.
Look at that hairpin turn. You're like the Stig. And Izzo goes around the first, but you got 21 seconds.
I'm pedal to the metal.
Put the throttle down.
Yep. This.
And he's in the follow through. Let's see. He's around Gambon. You don't have to hit all of them.
Just... I would like to. This is horribly boring.
Oh, look at that. Peeling out. How's that Reese cup coming in, Nelson? You hating life yet?
I am hating life. This is making me hate something I love.
When did you get a battle axe?
I don't know. That's awesome.
Yeah, if you go in there, you can make like a electrocution go kart thingy.
I'm not getting that go kart again. That was horrible.
I don't blame you, because that combo weapon handles even worse.
YB together. There you go. Oh! And that man is dead. He died.
Oh. That didn't feel good.
Almost, you're almost there though. That's a lot of peanut butter.
I know. I'm gonna need some water at the very least.
Man, you need milk. Give me your almond milk. Almond Brothers. That's all I can do so we don't get sued. That was less than 30 seconds, so we shouldn't get a copyright strike. You need to health up, hit down on the D-pad. There you go.
Drinking straight soda.
Izzo, would you use your bass guitar to absolutely save your life?
Not. Well, yeah, I would.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Oh, no. Oh, it's his head.
Oh, that's just flat. I feel like a guitar would be broken by now, especially after that hit.
I don't know. A bass is pretty heavy.
Yeah, but you just slammed into a concrete floor, basically. Tile floor. I think it would have broken it. I've seen enough Who concerts to know. And she's out.
She did.
When you just hit that female zombie, remind me of that scene in Deadpool. It's like, is it sexist to hit you? Is it sexist not to hit you? I'm so confused. You're gonna get killed by a Zamboni.
In 5 minutes.
Oh, that reminds me. So there was rumors going around that Ryan Reynolds had filmed an end credit scene for the Logan movie. Mm. And he has shot that down. He's like, no.
Oh, yeah.
Deadpool would not fit the tone of that movie. It's its own movie. No, no, no. So, which is good, because that's exactly what I thought. I was like, God, I hope Fox didn't do that.
I like how he was like, Prisoner 478 or whatever it was from Le Miz. Mm. I like how he referred to him as that in his tweet.
Yeah, so I'm glad they didn't do that, because that would have been terrible. You're almost there now.
It would have been so weird, too.
Home stretch. Mm. Are you just stabbing with fireworks? Yes, you are. Jeez! Go stab a couple of those guys in the crowd.
Did you hear how they're going to punish Rage Quitters in Street Fighter V?
Yes.
No, I didn't.
Oh, Josh, I'm surprised you didn't hear about that.
I know. I heard they were going to make them play with each other. But is there something else?
It was more.
They're going to embarrass them like, with like what, flags, right?
Yeah, basically, you get red badged.
Oh, nice.
You get scarlet lettered.
Yeah. Nice. Bravo, Capcom.
And cool. They're talking about doing that with more games, too.
They should.
Yeah. Because, like, basically, if you rage quit, you're going to get stuck with a badge on your name or in your game tag that you can't remove.
Mm-hmm. Good.
So, I thought that was awesome when they did that. I'm surprised you didn't hear about that.
Well, no, I kind of heard the story, but I didn't hear all of it because I was doing other things.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, I heard about how they were going to, like, one of the things was they were just going to make you play with other rage quitters.
Yeah.
Which is kind of funny. So does anybody ever finish that match?
No. They're just never going to get rid of that badge.
That's good. That's my thing. Like, I wish they would do that more multiplayer games. I always hate that, like, especially with the new Gears of War, how we were talking about how they don't have the bot fill anymore. So if someone quits on you, you're down a man. Mm-hmm. And that's the worst.
Or starting off completely...
Yeah, because there are certain... There are some games, like, if you're down a person, you are effed.
Yeah.
Like, sometimes you can make up for it, but, like, King of the Hill, if they've got an extra guy, you're screwed.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, Team Deathmatch, you can usually...
You might be able to squeak by.
Yeah, because everyone's going out for kills and stuff like that on their own. So usually you can just, as long as, like, your team has good players on it, you can make it through, but... You ain't... Combo!
Oh, nice!
Damn, history. 250 now are... Oh!
Running bulldog! Off the thing!
A la Chris Jericho.
And this is all without him using any of the skill points that he's earned you so far.
I know.
This is all stock.
Or any weapons. He's just...
Can
he make it to 300?
Izzo just wants to fight.
My name is Izzo, and I like to fight. Oh, is he finished? He's finished the...
Oh, my God.
The Reese Cup. You sure? We promised him a pound.
Mm-mm. I can't
do it. We promised the pound.
I'm not...
Then I've got to take a pound of flesh from you. Hold on.
You don't have to do any of that.
I got to get a pound of flesh.
Do I have anything to...
Pound of flesh or a pound of Reese's? Let's do this. Give me your hand.
No.
I'll take it out of your ass then.
I'm not doing any of that.
Bend over.
That is the last thing I thought you would ever say.
Yeah, there's other things I'd say to him. Running Bulldog again. Damn, 369. Get the 500. Oh, it's over. The kill streak's over. So that's on that bombshell.
Oh, man.
We're going to say Good night, Canada. Nice. But also, before we go, remember, click that subscribe button right there. There's going to be a video here somewhere. No, wait, I'm sorry, the subscribe button's here. Video here, video in this groinal area. So make sure you click those and click the little bell for the notifications. Good night.
Oh my gosh.
No, I can't move.
No. Oh, and he's up. Wait, I think a couple pieces of chocolate fell in here. You need to finish those two.
I'm not doing that.